Hi YouTube, it's Diana, aka It's Me Diana, or just Diana. So I'm sure you guys have already noticed that this is a Titanfall gameplay. It's like blowing up all over YouTube. But before I get into the gameplay and my first impressions and whatnot, I wanted to say a couple of thank yous to some people. First thank you goes out to Claymores. He actually gave me the first Titanfall beta code. He was out of town, so he couldn't play himself. So he gave me his code first, and I think I got it like Saturday morning. But I mean, it was really kind of him. He could have kept it for himself until he came back, or actually would have came back after the beta, but he could have given it to anybody else, but he gave it to me. So big huge thank you, and please check him out. His channel link will be in the description down below. Another huge thanks goes out to one of my subs, aka 4li45. He was actually kind and generous enough to give me a few codes to give away. First, he gave me a code right after Claymore's, and I obviously didn't need it anymore, but he told me to give it away to somebody who did need it, and then I also needed a PC code, and he was able to give me that too. So huge thank you to him. And I mean, people like him and Claymore's and Bertoli slash Mio actually gave me a PC code for a friend too. They give me hope into the COD community, and we all know that the COD community isn't the greatest at the moment. I mean, there are some, you know, shitty people, but I mean, people like them just really give me hope in the COD community, and I mean in the YouTube community too. But a huge thank you to those guys. Those guys are awesome. So anyway, let's go on to this gameplay. So this is an attrition gameplay on Fracture. Attrition is equivalent to team deathmatch. They're pretty much the same exact thing. So you get a different amount of points for the different things that you kill. Like a pilot is 100 points and grunts are like, I don't know, 1 point or something like that, and titans are different points too. But whoever reaches the 250 first wins the game. So I'm not gonna even lie, I'm not very good at this game. It's gonna take me a little while to get used to, just like how Call of Duty Ghost was. It took me like a good month or so to get used to Call of Duty Ghost, and I'm pretty sure it's probably gonna be about the same for this game too. This game, there's a lot of jumping and sliding and stuff like that, and very, you know, vertical stuff, and that is just like not me. There's a lot of like buildings and stuff that you have to climb on top of and run along the side of the buildings, and I'm just not good at stuff like that. Like, it reminds me a lot of like platform games like Super Mario. I'm terrible at Super Mario. God awful. And like, so at the end of every game, if you lose, you have to evacuate, and usually it's on top of like a building or something. Like, you have to go and climb into a ship on top of a building, and I never ever make it. I've made it once, and it was because it was not on top of a building. And I mean, it's a lot, it's hard for me to maneuver, but I'm pretty sure most of you other guys will probably get a lot, pick it up a lot faster than I will. So now that the beta is open on Xbox One and slowly opening up for PC, I'm sure you guys have figured out that we're only able to play two different maps and about three different game modes. So this map is called Fracture. I personally like it better than the other one. It's bigger, yes, and it's a lot more open, but it's less campy than the other one. The other one is called Angel City, which is like, you know, obviously a city and there's a bunch of buildings, but people like to camp on top of the roofs in that map, and it drives me nuts. I mean, it's a fucking beta. Why are you camping? Like, stats don't matter. It's whatever. And I mean, like, I was playing with JD last night and he said it right. I mean, that map's gonna be a fucking pain in the ass to play because people are gonna sit there and on top of roofs and in windows, and it's annoying. So the three game modes that we were able to play were Hardpoint Domination, which is pretty much domination. First team to reach 400 points wins the game. Attrition, which is this team deathmatch pretty much. And Last Titan Standing, which is kind of like Search and Destroy, but kind of not. I mean, there's no respawn, and you start off in Titans already, and you just have to eliminate the other team, and whoever has the last Titan standing, obviously, wins the round. And I think the score goes up to four, so whoever wins four rounds wins the game. And those games can be pretty lengthy. I mean, I think they're around like 15 to 20 minutes long, but it doesn't really seem like 15 20 minutes long, but I mean, they're pretty long. So I didn't get to play Titanfall as much as I hoped, but I will be uploading the different game modes and the different maps here in the next probably week or two. So my first impression, is it a Call of Duty killer? I don't think so. Is it fun? Yes. Is it funner than Ghost? I think so. The game length is about the same as an average Call of Duty Ghost game. I'm thinking domination terms. It's about 8 to 10 minutes, except for Last Titan Standing, obviously, which I said was about like 15 minutes, 15-20 minutes. But it doesn't feel as long as a ghost game does. I mean, you're running around constantly this whole time, jumping and, you know, shooting things down and whatnot. But in Call of Duty Ghosts, I feel like half the time I'm, like, running to find somebody to shoot. But I don't think it'll kill Call of Duty. I think it's too different to kill Call of Duty, honestly. I think it's smart that they're releasing it about 5 or 6 months after Call of Duty, because, you know, by now we're kind of all tired of Ghosts, and I mean, we want something new. So it's pretty smart of them to, you know, release it halfway through the title. But I think come November, when the new Call of Duty comes out, I think everybody will still buy that Call of Duty. The one thing I hope there will be when the new game comes out will be a no Titan playlist. I mean, Titans are cool and all, but sometimes they can be a little bit too much. Sometimes I just want to shoot people, not robots. I mean, at times, there'll be like 10 Titans on the map, and that's just too freaking much. That's just too much going on. And the other thing that was a little bit difficult for me was differentiating the pilots from the robots. I mean, they look too similar for me, and sometimes I'll go and shoot the grunt instead of the actual person and get killed by the actual person when, you know, the grunts are kind of stupid, so you can easily get away with just, you know, shooting the pilot and then shooting the grunt without really getting hurt or killed. But those are just things that I'll just get used to over time while playing this game. And a lot of people have been complaining about the smart pistols, which I haven't really run into that much, but I'm sure the annoyance will just amplify times 100,000 once the game gets rolling. So if you didn't catch that at the end, Reaper was like spraying this guy that was already in the ship, and that guy just like shoots him with one bullet and Reaper dies. Apparently there's like this shield that you can't shoot into the ship, but you can shoot out, so yeah, just FYI. But anyway, I am looking forward to the actual game coming out. It'll be a nice break from COD, and unfortunately I think the 360, y'all guys get it a few weeks after, you know, the PC and the Xbox One. But hope you guys enjoyed this video, so please like, subscribe, comment. Thanks. Bye.